ex-CIA, Stand AO, his excellent book. The Cosmic Conspiracy talks about President Carter's top secret Pentagon, project codenamed Noah's Ark, a system of some 96 underground bases. Today there are over 1,500 underground bases, they are paid by your tax dollars, and drug money from worldwide distribution of narcotics. It is now a proven fact that these underground bases exist. The Norwegian government leaked documents states they have built underground bases for the elite and personnel of importance that will be notified close to a catastrophe event.
Now you're laughing, Curtis, but we have tickets to go on a big ship. We will live, and you will die.
Has His Highness had an opportunity to study the dossier?
You must understand, I have a very big family, Mr.
Isaacs.
$1 billion is a lot of money.
I'm afraid the amount is in euros, Your Highness.
The highlight of the movie for me was when the US President and Italian Premier decided not to go on the Ark, but stay behind with the people. That must be a Hollywood inside joke. Those two in real life would push women and children to get to the front of the line. There is something that is predicted to happen in a few years. NASA scientists predict that there will be solar flare activities, which will have massive repercussions all around the world. The sun is going to go through an unusual series of solar flare cycles. The radiation that comes out of these solar storms, the electromagnetic energy will hit the Earth in a major way. A squadron of five NASA satellites called Themis found holes in the Earth's magnetic field. The Earth's magnetic field protects us from sunblasts, but now the shield of protection is down. This could cause all the electrical grids to fail for months, even years, causing worldwide panic and water and food shortages. Some scientists are claiming much more devastation from these sun activities. They are called reverse solar activity, which could cause weather calamities. But why so many toxic chemicals?
The Planets Today is a marvelous work of fiction. Oh, yes. Yes, there is no such thing as Planet Nimburu or whatever they say. It's just fiction. And they cite sources that cite NASA sources. They don't cite NASA. Check the websites, you'll see. And it's all related to the doomsday predictions of the year 2012. Yes, that's what you're getting at. That's behind your question, isn't it? Combined with on December 21st, 2012, that the center of the galaxy, the sun and the earth, will come into perfect alignment, and the excess gravity will then also tip earth off its axis, and it'll be end of the world as we know it. This is what these web pages will tell you. Turns out, if you go to December 21st and look at the star charts, it's true. The center of the galaxy, the sun and the earth, will come into perfect alignment. It will. It's true. It's true. What the site does not tell you is that that happens every year on December 21st. They left that out of the account.
He does not, of course, mention sun flare activity, or the holes in the magnetic fields, or even the bizarre weather patterns and strange volcanic activity that's happening today.